Three Marshall County jailers called for police backup in May of last year after William Jennette refused to get into a restraint chair.
Where are you?
Right now!
When Lewisburg police officer Christopher Stallings runs into the room, Jennette yells that corrections officers are trying to kill him.
Help me, they're killing me!
They quickly get Jennette to the floor, where he will die minutes later.
It just breaks my heart because he was someone worth knowing, you know?
His daughter, Dominique Jennette, says her 48-year-old father was terrified and desperately needed help.
That's just something that really sticks with me, of how scared he must have been and how alone he must have felt.
Jail logs show Jennette had been hallucinating and detoxing after being arrested 2 days earlier for resisting arrest, public intoxication, and indecent exposure. Officers had put him in a restraint chair the day before because he was hitting his head on the cell wall. But on May 6th, officers tried again. As you see on these jail cameras with no sound, things escalated quickly.
They should have been more aware. They should have been trained properly, and they weren't.
Dominique is suing Marshall County and the Lewisburg Police Department because of what happened after her father was on the ground.
Stay down, you stupid son of a—
With other officers now around him, Jennette is face down on the floor in handcuffs.
Get up!
Despite his screams, officers put pressure on his back and then call for leg restraints.
Go get your leg restraints before you do anything else. Get leg restraints.
Seconds later, Jennette says for the first time that he can't breathe. Listen to what a female officer says back to him.
You said you can't breathe, you stupid.
Officers stay on his back and even bend his legs to his back. Until finally, one officer says, be careful of suffocating him.
Hey, easy, easy. Remember, it's fictional asphyxiation, guys.
Got it.
That's why I'm not on his lungs. Let him breathe.
Jennette's last words are, I'm good. But an officer with his knee on Jennette's back talked back to him.
Oh, you ain't good. You gonna lay right there for a minute.
That's the exact opposite of what this generally accepted police training has taught officers to do for at least the last 25 years.
We showed the video to law professor and former police officer Seth Stoughton. He's co-written a book, Evaluating Police Uses of Force.
When the handcuffs come on, they should have rotated the guy to the side.
He was disturbed by what he saw and said police departments have been trained since the mid-90s about the dangers of positional asphyxiation, suffocating someone by sitting on their back in what's called the prone position.
There's approximately a 3-minute and 43-second period after officers have applied handcuffs where they keep the individual in the prone position, and that's not acceptable.
Like, all that he wanted was help, and all that he got was hate. Like, it's not right.
Jennette's daughters remember him as a father of five who drove a cement truck to support them. He'd been arrested before, but did not have a long rap sheet.
There were so many people that could have just said, this isn't right, and no one said that this wasn't right.
The autopsy lists the cause of death as acute combined drug intoxication with meth in his system. But it also listed asphyxia as a contributory cause of death and ruled it a homicide.
It just feels like my heart is constantly being ripped out of my chest. And there's no peace to that.
This family hopes other departments learned from what happened to their dad.
He's not there, like, to take me home anymore.